Gold prices continue to trade the 1800 level, today dipping just below it for a brief period, but ultimately coming back above, settling around 1805. Yes, that's a little bit lower on the day, but we continue our string of settlements above 1800 going back to July 6th. So it's been a pretty steady trade. We have seen some moments below. We have seen several days above, even extending higher, but ultimately coming back to this 1800 level like a magnet, almost like it's waiting for something. There's some news out there or some event that possibly could take us, you know, to the moon or back to those lows that we saw not too long ago. So ultimately right now, gold holding on, despite the fact that we've seen treasury yields decline 30 basis points over a period of a week, and in 2 days rally 20. We've seen the stock market sell off 2% to rally 3%. We've seen cryptos get hit as well, and they rallied, and yet gold remains right there at 1800, not seeing a whole lot of price movement like we're typically used to. Those are the things that used to cause gold to move around: higher yields, higher cryptos, lower yields, lower cryptos, more risk on. We've seen all those things move gold prices up and down, but we haven't seen that in the biggest underlier, the dollar, which has been rallying recently. We haven't seen that affected. And then in the last couple of days, we've seen the dollar come off. That hasn't affected either. So gold kind of on an island on its own, waiting for some catalyst moment that could come next week. We'll talk about that in a moment. Now, what does that mean for volatility? Well, when you sit there and you trade the same price ranges or very close, very tighter price ranges, you tend to see volatility trade flat, and that's what we're seeing. I would expect to see some kind of an uptick in volatility given the event risk that we have for next week, but we haven't really seen that. So volatility remains pretty steady as the price underlying prices remain right at that 1800 level. And lastly, I want to talk about those speculators and what we have next week. Speculators have started to add to their longs again, something that we hadn't seen in quite a while. And ultimately, despite the fact that we're seeing other markets move around so volatilely, and we're not seeing that in gold, possibly is because the speculators are waiting for that set event. And what is that event next week? Well, we have the July FOMC meeting. Not a quarterly meeting, not one where we're going to get any forward guidance, but we will get a press conference. We will get to hear what the Fed says, and clearly with the inflation versus growth argument, that's been that tug of war between the market right now, kind of looking at that inflation as being transitory and looking at fear of economic growth if there are any more lockdowns put in place globally, has the market kind of turned on its side. And we saw that really more vividly in stocks and bonds this week than we did anywhere else. So right now, speculators, I think, waiting for possibly more of a dovish Fed. There's no other reason for them to be holding on to their longs or a weaker dollar. That means the Fed will keep rates lower for longer and probably not see any sort of tapering or talking of tapering in the near term. But again, we'll get that meeting next week, and that's likely what these speculators are holding on to their longs for. We will get an update from the CFTC on Friday for numbers as of Tuesday, so it'll be interesting to see if they still are holding on. We haven't seen any big price drops in gold, which would suggest they're getting out, so it's my sense that they're still holding on. So gold prices continue to hold that 1800 level, and likely will do so as we enter the mid part of this week, looking ahead next week to July FOMC.